do this. I'll kick off my little house shoes. Okay, everyone. We're going to start on your backs. Come on down onto your back. And in case anybody is new to me watching back on demand, or if you snuck in live and I didn't see you, my name is Maeve. This is little mister. He's my yoga partner. Come on to your backs. If you have a strap, you can use it, but it's really not important. I'm not going to use one even though I have a strap right there. You're going to pull your right knee toward your chest, but not like all the way in, just like a half bend here. Broaden across the chest. Take a breath in. And then exhale, push the leg away from you. Inhale, soften the knee. And then exhale, push the leg away. And you're gonna just keep moving like that with your breath. So there's an inhale to soften and an exhale to extend, creating pressure on the leg, moving the leg away from your torso. And as you're doing this, every time you inhale and soften the knee, see if you can deepen that hip crease just a little bit more. So that sense of, instead of the hip hiking up, that the hip is actually kind of settling in. And if it's helpful, you can actually use your right hand to get a sense of that. And then as you're building this sort of gentle rhythm with the breath, with this pretty easy-ish movement here, start to build some strength in the left leg, the leg that's down. And the next time you straighten the leg, you're gonna hold it up. And you're gonna take your hand straight up toward that right foot, but without actually touching. And then engage all the muscles of the leg. Okay, even the calf, like can you kind of squeeze if you point, or if you flex, can you wake up the calf, wake up the quadricep, the hamstring? And then maybe the leg starts to move toward you, but without touching, keep pushing down into the left leg. So now there's a little more work here. The work of extending the leg, of hugging the muscles into the bones. Take a breath here in. Exhale, curl your shoulders up and hold it here. And then consider floating this left leg up off the ground. You can point or flex your feet. I don't care, but just wake up your ankles, please. Maybe do a little bit of both. Maybe even circle the feet around. And then slowly release the spine down, release the left leg down, release the right leg all of the way. And then just take a little pause. And then bring the left knee in. And it's like a soft bend. It's not like you're not jamming the knee up into the chest. Take the hamstring, inhale, and then exhale, straighten the leg. And we'll do the exact same thing on this side. So gently moving with the breath, the inhale softens the knee, the exhale presses the leg straight. And the hands are really just creating some tension here. The arms are creating some tension for you to press into. And again, as you're doing this, starting to feel the hip crease of the left leg, that left hip, moving toward the right foot a little bit. The right leg is active, the heel is pushing down. And the next time you straighten, you're going to hold it up. Good. And then reach the arms up. Push into that right leg and then start to move the left leg towards you. Maybe it might not move at all. Maybe it's more of just an intention than an actual visual. Take a breath in. Exhale, curl the shoulders, reach the hands forward, and then maybe float that right leg up. And then wake up your feet. So maybe point and flex a few times, maybe circle the ankles, or maybe just pick one thing and stay. Good. And then this time, bring the legs toward each other. Reach the legs forward and then rise up into Navasana. And then just stay there for a few breaths. Just stay for a few breaths. I'm going to make sure everybody's on mute so that we don't get any feedback. Good, bring the feet down, lift the heart up. And then exhale, reach the left arm forward, the right arm back. But don't make contact with anything with the arms. Just find a twist here. Try to scoop the belly back. Notice how your hip flexors might want to kind of really flare up here. Lift up a little higher and maybe go easier on the twist. Push the feet down. Come back up to center, inhale. And then exhale the other way. Back up to center, cross your shins, and downward facing dog. Few breaths here. Right foot forward, left knee down, Anjaneyasana, rise up, push down to the feet, push the front foot down and drag it toward the back of your mat, push your back foot down, drag it toward the front of the mat, back knee presses down, pull it toward the front of the mat, take a breath here, and then exhale, straighten the front leg and just release the hands down. Couple breaths here, Ardha Hanumanasana. We're not gonna be here long, so don't get crazy on me and extending legs out. Just be here. Inhale, come right back up, reaching the arms up, heart rising, Anjaneyasana, and then releasing back down, Ardha Hanumanasana. Inhale. And exhale. So even more than the actual poses, I know this sounds crazy, but even more than the actual poses, getting a sense of these transitions and controlling the transitions, maybe even not using your hands at all, sweeping the arms back behind you, so that you're really connecting ground down, foundation, to control the movement, rather than just catching yourself. One more time each. Bring the hands around, step back, downward facing dog. Hip forward plank, all the way to your belly. Hands reach back, feet reach back, Shalabhasana. Heart forward. Imagine you have a block between your hands. Try to squeeze that imaginary block. Hands to ribs, knees, toes, lift up, downward facing dog. Step your left foot forward, right knee down. Anjaneyasana, take a few breaths here. Yeah. Sweet. And so without me constantly saying all the same things, how do you build some resistance here? How do you create some strength here? You know how. I just told you, and I say it pretty much every single class. Release the hands down and straighten the front leg. Dig that front heel in. Use your back foot. Toes can be tucked or toes can be down, but push the foot down. Moving between these two poses. Inhale. And exhale. attending these transitions. And then as you're here and you get the movement pattern, you start to feel more confidence. See if you can float the arms up. So we're really looking to build control and strength here, not just to be able to drop into a split. And honestly, if that's one of your goals, it's the strength and control that's going to get you there, not the, I mean, there's some level of softer passive stretching that will help, but really to get you there safely, you need this strength, I promise you. Last round. And then hands come forward. Down dog. Forward to plank. Exhale to belly. Shavasana again. Reach back. Good, hands down. Push up and back, downward facing dog. Walk your hands back to your feet. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Bring your hands onto your shins. Get really long in your spine. Try to get your spine parallel to the floor so you can come up as high as you need to with your hands to get there. And then bring your hands into your heart and stay here. One more inhale. Bring your thumbs to your third eye, center of your forehead, and bow down. Inhale, press into the feet. Use your hips, use your legs. Engage those glutes to rise up. And then draw your hands into your heart with your exhale. Just a half salute, just a half salute. I'm gonna call today, look ma, no hands. Inhale, rise up. And then exhale, hands, thumbs to forehead, bow forward. Glide your hands to your heart, come halfway. And then exhale, fold back down, thumbs back to the forehead. Inhale, rise all the way up. And hands back into your heart. We're gonna do that two more times. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, bowing forward. Heart forward, inhale, bow down, exhale, rise, inhale, hands into your heart, exhale, one more time, inhale, exhale, bow, halfway, inhale, fold back down, exhale, rise, inhale, hands into your heart, exhale, step to the top of your mat. Same thing, inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale. Now step your right foot back. Crescent pose, reach up. Couple breaths here, get into your center. One more breath in. Hands down to the ground, step back to plank. Take a breath in, all the way to the floor. Cobra, inhale. And then soften down, exhale. Tuck the toes, lift up, downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward. Rising up, crescent pose. Couple breaths here. Watch the transition. Tipping forward, step the left foot forward, forward fold. Halfway inhale, hands into your heart, and then fold back down, exhale. Rise up, inhale, and then draw your hands into your heart. So move a little bit faster. Inhale and rise.
Don't you lose your warrior spirit.
And on the exhale, bow forward. Come halfway, inhale. Step your left foot back. Inhale, crescent. And down. Step back, plank. Again, all the way to your belly, please. Cobra. And then downward facing dog. Left foot forward. Rise to crescent. And then come forward. Step the right foot forward. Notice that transition. Halfway inhale. Hold back down. Rise up, inhale. And then hands to your heart. We're gonna go two more times. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway inhale. Step your right foot back. Lengthen up to crescent. Hands down. Step back. Lower all the way to the ground again. This time, Sphinx, pull the heart forward. Take a few breaths here. We haven't been in this back bend yet. Tuck your toes. Come into forearm plank. Use your hips. Come back to Sphinx. And then release, downward facing dog. Right foot steps forward. Crescent, rise up. And then release, top of the mat, forward fold. Halfway inhale. Fold back down, exhale. Rise, inhale. And draw your hands to your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Halfway inhale. Fold down, exhale. Good. Come halfway again. I just want a couple extras here with no hands. Get this sense of using your legs. Do that one more time. Inhale, lengthen. Good. Now left foot steps back. Crescent pose. Bring the hands down. Step back. Lower to your belly. Sphinx. Forearm plank. Stay. Release down, come back to Sphinx, inhale. Release that, downward facing dog. Exhale. Left foot steps forward. Rising up, crescent. Good, control this. No hands if you can. Step that right foot forward, bow down. Come halfway with your inhale. And then fold again. Rise, inhale. And hands into your heart. Exhale. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway inhale. Good. Now reach your hands down to the ground. Shift forward into your hands. And then step back, plank. Chaturanga. Rise and open, inhale. Upward facing dog, cobra, shalabhasana. Downward facing dog, exhale. So we've gone through quite a few back ones already. There are, all those versions are there and available for you to choose from in that transition to downward facing dog. And you can, of course, skip it all together. Heels up, inhale. Knees bend. Look forward. Feet to your hands. Good. Slide your hands to your heart. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale and fold. Reach to rise, inhale, hands into your heart, exhale, inhale, rising up, exhale, bowing forward, try not to use your hands, please, just the legs nice and strong, halfway, inhale, now bring your hands down, shift into your hands, step back or jump back, chaturanga, Inhale, opening your choice of back bend. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. And then fold. I forgot to tell you to pick up your hands. Inhale and rise. It's okay, we got another round. And then draw your hands into your heart. Inhale, rise up. I forgot to tell you because I was busy in my thoughts. Exhale, forward fold. I was thinking how not using your hands here, inhale halfway, helps you on that jump forward. Hands down and on that jump back, believe it or not, because you're building this strength in the legs, in your center, to start to control those movements more. Lift your heels, inhale. Bend your knees, exhale, look forward, bring your feet to your hands. And climb up to the heart, inhale, lengthen. And then fold down. Rise, inhale. And then draw your hands into your heart, exhale. Pick up your right knee. Good. Good, knee stays up. No hands, no hands. Take this knee as high as you can first, and then out to the right. And then lift it a little higher still. No hands, no hands. Bring your foot to your inner leg, wherever it hits. Knee, perfect. Good. Don't reach down and pull it up. Don't do it. You know I'm dying to do that right now. Don't do it. Meet the pressure. Arms reach up. Beautiful. Inhale, knee to center. Extend the leg out. Don't lean back. Bring your right foot down to the ground. Stand on your right leg. Open halfway. Little containment in the low belly. Lengthen out the low back. Take the tailbone for your left heel. Powerful both legs. Powerful in both legs. Bend the right knee. Lean a little forward. And then slowly stretch that left leg back. And then come into warrior two. Bring the hands behind the back. Reach the fingers down. Don't waste the hands. Just draw the shoulders open. Gently contain the front ribs. Gently contain the front ribs. Don't lace your hands. Don't lace your hands. Inhale, reach both arms up. Sink a little deeper, pull the feet toward each other, and then reverse warrior, both arms go up and back. Feel that inner right thigh wrapping just a little open. Balance the weight in the front foot. Balance the weight in the back foot. Good. Reach forward, reach forward, reach forward, reach forward. And then right arm onto that right thigh. So I won't make you do that in side angle yet. Not yet, anyway. Open up the chest a bit more. One more inhale. And then bring your hands around. Step back. Plank. Chaturanga. Or your path to down dog. Listen, right leg stretches back. Right leg stretches back. Right foot steps forward. Lift your hands to your heart. Come up halfway with your spine and then lift that left leg behind you at the same time. Warrior three. So we kind of did this on your back. Not kind of, we did. And when we're laying on your back, so if this was right leg lifted, left leg on the floor, you were pushing your left heel down. So now you're pushing your left heel up to the sky and pushing the leg long. So it's not just about like, you don't have to break the plane. Imagine there's you're like up against the ceiling. Push the heel up, pull the belly in, and then draw up on that standing leg. That's the leg, it's this. It's 100% this. Well, this. Same thing. Same shape, I should say. Chair, bring the feet together. Rise up, left knee lifts up. Good. Don't touch the knee. Take the knee as high as you can. You can bring your hands back to your heart. And then keep it high. Take it out to the left. Work that standing leg. Lift the knee as high as you can and bring your left foot inside of your right leg. Wherever. Half, knee, whatever it wants to touch. And then if it's good, arms up. Good, draw the knee forward, leg up. Bring the left foot down, you're gonna stand on your left foot. Opening half moon. Yes. We were here for like 45 minutes on the first side, so get into it. Find that extension in the leg. So even if it's like you need to find that little bend to find the extension, don't just like drop into the joints and hang there. You want to feel like you're extending the whole time, actively. And then start to soften the front knee. Lean a little forward. That's going to help you slowly transition into warrior two. Good. This time, bring the elbows in front. Good. Don't touch the arms together. Just bring them in front. And then bring the elbows to touch and pull the hands apart. Mm-hmm. Lift the elbows a little higher. Sink a little deeper in the hips. Sweep both arms up and then reverse. Thank you. Rise up. Left arm onto the forearm. Up, forearm onto the leg. Left arm onto the forearm. Arm onto the arm. Arm to thigh. Good, pull the feet toward each other. As you do that, can you maybe sink a little deeper into that left hip and hug it under your body? So finding lots of expansiveness here. Take one more breath in, and then bring your hands around. Sit back to plank, your path to down dog. And then left leg stretches back, inhale. Exhale, place the left foot forward. Bring the hands into your heart. Start to lift the spine halfway up and follow through with that right leg. Virabhadrasana 3. So you can imagine you're lying on your back. You're pushing your right heel into the floor. Finding length from the crown of the head, along the spine, along that right leg to the foot. And then you're working the strength of that left leg to straighten it. With your next inhale, arrive in chair. Good, left knee lifts up. Open up half moon. All right. Left hand on your left hip and keep it there. Bend your left leg. Don't touch your foot. Try to pull the foot to your hip. And then start to move the left thigh bone back behind you. Don't take your foot. Don't take your foot. Keep pulling the heel to your butt. Move the knee back. More. Come on, give me more. Give yourself more. Good. Start to bend that right knee. Stretch the left leg back behind you. Step back, bring the hands back behind you. Turn the palms away from each other. Think a little deeper. And then reverse order. Come forward, side angle. Maybe right hand floor, left arm overhead. And then come around. Right leg sweeps up and back. Come high into your left toes, bend your left knee, and then hop your left foot forward. Hands into your heart, warrior 3. Bend the right leg. Pull the heel toward your sitting bone. More. Yep. Chair. Sink down. Toes stand. Right heel. Sorry, both heels down. So that was a mess up. Both heels down. We're going to do that in a minute. Not quite yet. Both heels down. Hands into your heart. Think as deeply as you can. Rock toward the toes. Take the torso down. Use your belly. Come back into chair. Heels down the foot. Exhale, sink deeper, hands into heart. Toe stand, tip the torso forward, lift the hips up a little bit. And then back into chair. You got one more like that. Bring your hands into your heart. Tip forward. Chest goes down. Hips come up. take an extra pause here. And then left heel down. Right heel stays up, rise up to stand. Good. Half moon. Right hand on your right hip. Bend the right leg, don't take your foot. Try to get your heel as close to your hip as you can and then start to move this right thigh back in space. A little more, don't give up on it. I know there's a point where like you wanna just like let it go, right? Don't let it go. If you wanna reach back and touch your hamstring to see what's happening there, you go for it. Good. Bend the standing leg. Stretch the right foot back. Arrive in warrior two legs, bring the arms out in front. Don't touch the arms together. Lift the elbows up. Sink a little deeper. Stretch the arms up. Reverse warrior. Control, bring it forward. Side angle, arm thigh, hand floor block. And then bring the hand around. Left leg up and back, three-legged dog. Come high into the right toes. Bend the right knee, look forward, hop the right foot forward, keep the left leg lifted. Hands come into your heart. Warrior three. And then start to bend the leg. Left leg, that is. Pull the heel toward the hip. Pull the heart forward. Lift the thigh a little higher. Good. Come into toe stand. Hands into your heart. Lift your hips up, tip your chest forward. See if you can find a little balance here. Good, now start to press your wrists into your knees and start to pull the heart forward. Keep that length, bring your hands down to the ground. Shift some weight into your hands. Stay here, slide your knees up into your triceps. And then you're gonna drop the chest forward a little bit in order to lift the hips and the feet up. And then you start to play with that. That kind of like seesaw. And then however you want, chaturanga, vinyasa, or straight to down dog. Beautifully done. Yes, yes, yes. Right leg back, inhale. Right knee, right tricep. Inhale back. Exhale, knee to chest. Inhale back. Exhale, cross. Inhale back. Place your foot forward. Half moon on the right leg. Good. Right hand to your right, I'm sorry, left hand to your left hip. Bend that left knee. Pull the heel in as close to your hip as you can. Stay here or happy relief, right? Find your foot and your hand together and then push away. Push the foot into the hand, hand holds on. Good. Warrior two. Bend the front leg. Lean a little forward. Good. This time bring the hands behind the hips. Lace the hands. Oh, joy of joys, right? Pull the knuckles down. Draw the chest open. Breathe into your biceps with your back ribs. And then sweep both arms back. Reverse warrior. Good. This time, if you can, both arms come forward in side angle. No contact. And then release your hands down. Right leg sweeps up and back. Come high in your left toes. Look forward, hop your left foot forward. Rise to warrior three. Good. Now this time, come up with your right knee lifted. And then pull the foot up and back. Good. Mm-hmm. You know what you're doing here, right? You're pulling your foot toward your hip. You start to move the thigh bone back. And then reach back slowly. I haven't even made contact yet. Okay, and then we get to open. Push away.
You gave me a shoulder when I needed it.
Toe stand.
You showed me love when I wasn't feeling it.
Hands down.
You helped me fight.
Possibly Bakasana. And then whatever your path down dog. From down dog, left leg back, inhale. And then left knee, left arm, exhale. Inhale back. Exhale down the center. Inhale back. And then cross. One more time, back inhale. Place your left foot forward. Lifting forward, half moon. Right hand to your right hip, roll the shoulder open. Bend the right leg. Pull the foot in as much as you can. And then find the foot. And then push away. Bend the standing leg. Reach the right foot back. Warrior two. Bring your arms in front. Make contact with the forearms if you can, and then lift the elbows up. Sink a little deeper in the hips. Lift up. Push the arms together. Spread the shoulder blades. And then reach up and reverse it back. And then bring it forward. And then release the hands down. Three-legged dog, left leg to sky. High in the right toes. Look forward, hop the right foot forward. And then lift. Warrior three. Rise up to stand and then pull the left knee in. Up and in. Pull the foot to the hip. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Keep pulling the foot up, keep pulling the foot up. Good. So feel, maybe even just take your hand to that left hamstring. It's awake. Reach back, take the foot if you want. And then push the foot away. Good, toe stand. Good, now listen. Split the knees. Bring your hands down. Stay in the toes if you can. And then with the arms inside of the knees, just bring your hands to prayer if it's okay. And then gently squeeze in with the knees and gently press out with the elbows. And then slowly, maybe the heels come down, maybe they don't, maybe the feet separate a lot or a little, maybe they stay right where they are. Play with it. And then take the hands wide, palms turn toward the sky, and bring your hands back by your heels if you can. Press the triceps into the shins or whatever you're in contact with. Let the upper back round. And then at the same time, start to pull the heart forward. So there's this balance. Upper back is rounding, shoulder blades are widening, heart is pulling forward. Arms and legs mostly arms pushing into legs because legs are pretty stationary here. And then gently release, hands down to the ground. Bring the knees inside of the arms, tip forward, step to plank, lower to your belly. Good. Bring your forearms around so your hands are just kind of crossed in front. Let your torso rest down. You don't have to have your head down though. Bend both of your legs. Pull your heels toward your sitting bones. Ugh, more of this, right? Lift the legs up. I like to put my feet together just because it gives me a little bit more power. Yeah, it's a little bit of a cheat if you want to call it what it is, but it gives me a little more feedback. Keep the low back long, keep breathing, pull the heels in. Good. Release the legs, curl, cobra or upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Exhale, pause and breathe. Right leg back, inhale. Right knee, right tricep, exhale. Inhale back. Cross to the left, exhale. Inhale back. Place your right foot forward. Warrior one, rising up. Bend the front leg a lot. Bring the hands behind your back. Do not lace your fingers. Don't lace your fingers. Pull the palms toward each other, broaden the chest. Front ribs, draw gently back and soften down. Mm-hmm. So you've got like a very precious item behind your back. Whatever that might be, your lunch, a vase, a child, something, nothing that heavy, but you know what I mean. Something you're holding behind. You've got to squeeze in. You don't want to drop it. Sweep the arms up, inhale, chaturanga, exhale, or not, maybe right to down dog. My wish for you is that every time you pass through that transition to come into down dog, you feel a little stronger than you did the first time, or the last time, for that matter. So picking things that allow you to feel that way. Left leg back, inhale, left knee, left tricep, exhale. Inhale back, and then exhale, cross. Inhale back and exhale, bring your foot forward. Warrior one, rising up. Good, just get your feet about you. Good, bring the hands behind the back. Same thing, don't lace the fingers. Good, now this time, can you turn the palms forward and start to pull the thumbs back a little bit? So the palms might even start to open out, maybe. Find a little lift in the front of the hips, a little softening in the back of the hips, a little containment in the belly, in the lower rib cage. Yes. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, chaturanga or not. Right leg back, inhale. Good, right knee, right tricep. Put your left knee down. Left knee down, right knee on your right tricep. Mm-hmm. Pull the knee up higher. Shouldn't feel like a break. Pull the heel up. Good. Start to bend the elbows, shift forward. Maybe extend that right leg. Maybe extend the left leg. Maybe lift up and then curl your left heel toward your left hip. Left foot down, right leg sweeps up and back, and then cross over to the left. stay here. You can put your knee down. It's a little trickier with the twist, but you can put your knee down. Hold it there. Maybe extend the right leg. Maybe extend the left leg. And then same thing. Ooh, right leg up and back. And then right leg comes forward. Right knee toward your right elbow. Right foot toward your left elbow. Hold and breathe. Lift higher. And then glide the leg down. Pigeon, lift up. Hands into your heart if it's okay. Give pressure downward. I'm pretty lifted here. So this is my down. This is where I am. Come forward just a little bit. Forward folding. See how that then forces the front shin to do more. Keep that. Rise back up. You've got a couple options here. You can either bring it forward, release it down, or you can bend the back leg, maybe take the foot in any shape or form and start to open here. You can play with it however you want. Two more breaths, not a long one. Good, hands come under the shoulders. Right leg to the sky, open the hip. Stay here if this feels good. If you want, square the hips, not where you were thinking, I know. Hop the left foot just a smidge closer. And then maybe take some kick-ups for handstand. Yes. And then make your way back to downward facing dog, however you want to get there. So good. So good. And then left leg stretches back, inhale. Left knee to left tricep. Shift forward, put your right knee down. Stay here. Try to pull the knee up higher. Maybe extend that left leg out. Maybe push the right leg to straight, and then maybe shift and lift. And then right leg back, lift up, left leg, and then cross over to the right. So same thing, you can put the right knee down, maybe extend the leg. You can just work there. You don't have to take this into the arm bounce. If you want, extend the left leg, straighten the right leg, shift forward, and then maybe find that little scorpion kind of back leg. You got it. And then up and back. And then left knee to left tricep, left foot toward your right elbow. Hold and breathe. And then release it down. And then like a high pigeon. This is like a pigeon on the move. Looking for some seeds, some breadcrumbs, a French fry. Hinge forward. Feel how that front leg has to work. Keep that. Lift back up. Good. And then you decide where you want to go with it. Last few breaths. Hands come under the shoulders. Tuck the right toes. Three-legged dog. Open the hip. Stay there if you'd like. Yeah, you can flip it into wild thing. I know that's where you thought I was going to take you, but I didn't. If you want, instead, hop that right foot a little closer and then take a couple hops here. Excellent. Really nice. And then back to down dog. Both knees come down to the ground. And child's pose. Really, really well done. Good, rise up. Come onto your backs. If you'd rather stay sitting and stay up there for the finish of your practice for meditation seated, you're welcome to. You're gonna bring the soles of the feet together, Supta Baddha Konasana. And Supta Baddha Konasana, giving yourself a release here. If this doesn't feel good, consider doing the exact opposite, putting the feet wider than your hips, dropping the knees in toward the center. Feel the strength of the ground under you. Receive any feedback that your body is giving you. And if there's anything you need to do before Shavasana, I shouldn't say anything. If there's like one or two things that you need to do, you're going to do that now. If you're ready, you'll just extend the legs out. So we have this idea that we have to always do the same things before Shavasana because they're habits, because it's like a ritual. And maybe we don't need to do them. Maybe you do need them. Maybe you don't need them. And that's where I'm giving you the power to make that decision. And when you've arrived in stillness, it's like a fluid stillness. It's not a rigid stillness. If there's something that's requiring you to move, do it. But if it's not, if it's not important in this moment, let it go. Notice your mind in this moment. This practice isn't here to teach you to control your mind. It's almost exactly the opposite. It's to allow you to be an observer of your mind, of your body, of yourself. Most of the time, not really feeling like you necessarily need to change anything, just observing. And just like when we observe our breath, even when we don't intend to change it, we typically do when we watch it. So watching the thoughts play out in your mind. Start to wake up your hands and your feet. And then whatever your course is to find a seated position, you'll take that now. And then once you've found your way to sitting, you'll bring your hands into your heart in prayer. Take your time, take your time. So in this last moment together, it's still personal, you're still in. I like to think of this as like a time to honor your story, like your story in this practice today. What was your story? Our stories don't have to define us, right? They're just in the moment. So this is just one practice, and tomorrow will be a different practice. But what was your story today? What was your storyline? How do you feel about that story? And what things can you just kind of leave behind, and which things do you want to bring with you? Bow your mind to your heart with your exhale. Rise with your inhale. Allow your eyes to open gently. Thank you for your practice. Happy weekend. Happy Friday. I will see you all, hopefully, if not tomorrow, I will see you next week. If you have questions, you need anything.